In the streets of Warsaw, there is a place that many people walk past, since at first, it doesn't seem like anything out of the ordinary. That's until they take a closer look. Keep watching to find out what it is that these people find so interesting. The world's narrowest house. One day, a man was heading back home when he noticed a clear space between two buildings. He stopped for a moment in order to take a closer look. It was a small spot that was not even 5 feet wide. He also couldn't help but notice that there was some rubbish and old furniture that was dumped there. That man was Jakub Szczesny, and as an architect, he saw the space as more than a mere dumping ground, and rather as a place to live. He thought a little deeper about what kind of person could live in a house like that, since it was pretty compact and therefore would not be as functional as others. Then he thought about hermits, people who would be comfortable spending a lot of time alone. Maybe the house could be for someone who is working? This moment led to the birth of Carrot House, the world's narrowest house, which boasts a width that measures exactly 4 feet. When developing the design for the house, Jakub asked for the involvement of an Israeli writer, Edgar Carrot, who became the patron of the house and its namesake. Edgar is the one who decides who can rent the property. They decided that the purpose of the house is to provide a temporary spot for traveling writers. These are people who are primarily focused on working and are thus not too fussy regarding their living space. Considering the size, it can only really fit a single inhabitant. It contains all the things required of a typical house, such as a living room or bathroom, but the space makes moving around less than practical. Jakub said that a person who chooses to live there needs to have a sense of humor, since it isn't a place where you can stay for a long time. The shape of the house is quite unique. It's a triangle, with the narrowest point being just over 2 feet. Once you get a chance to look at the design up close, you'll get to appreciate the vision that these men had when designing it. It's a lot more of an art project than a normal house. But that's exactly what the designers intended. There is supposed to be a sort of impossibility about the structure of the house. People are supposed to look at it and wonder, how could someone live there? For many years now, people have been visiting the Carrot House, since it has gained icon-level status in Poland. The Polish Modern Art Foundation, which supports the project, has commented on the house, saying, "We deeply believe it will become a symbol of modern Warsaw ingrained in its complicated history. The house attracted the attention of the media from the entire world. We hope it will show the most fascinating side of Warsaw, an eel bed." In the past decade, there has been a significant rise in the number of narrow houses built, and Japan is one of the leading countries. Similar to the Carrot House, a Japanese studio has designed a house in between two already existing buildings. Although this Tokyo house is not as narrow as the Carrot one, its width is still impressive, considering that it is only 6 feet. The architects say that this small and narrow piece of land is a typical eel's bed site, where one can reach his or her arm from the left to the right wall. Due to the slim size of this four-story building, the designers put a lot of thought into the interior structure. Although these eel bed buildings are increasing in popularity, one of the biggest problems that architects have to consider is the lighting. The designers of this house explain how they have tried to utilize the floor difference so that light and fresh air can flow into every corner of the house. The staircase is located at the back of the building and has been structured in a way to accommodate the lighting. They wanted to create as much open space as possible for the residents, keeping in mind how a person would feel to be living inside it. One way they tried to create a sense of depth is by painting the walls dark, rather than going for a typical light color. Another benefit of doing this is that the window walls, which you can see from this picture, are emphasized. This house is only one of many residences that are going down the environmentally and economically friendly route of narrow houses. Blemen House. As previously mentioned with the last house, Japan has been developing many of these narrow houses. Another example would be the Blemen House, also situated within Tokyo. The aim of this house is to provide a home that is conveniently located and yet still affordable for people living within the city. According to Japanese building law, on that site, the maximum number of stories that can be built is 3. There were already many tall buildings in the area. Although this posed some difficulties in the functionality of the house, they were able to overcome this problem by allowing having large windows as well as adapting the structure of the ceiling. Structurally, the house is like a more spacious Carrot House, since they both share a triangular design. However, the triangular aspect of the Blevins house is concentrated only on the ceiling. The rest of the house is quite rectangular and allows for a lot more movement. Like the eel bed house, allowing a lot of natural light into the house was one of the things that these designers tried to focus on. There is one room that has been developed to use natural light in order to eliminate living room, dining room, bedroom, as well as kitchen. Although this house considers the aesthetics, its primary goal is to create a compact but functional home for a couple. This house takes into consideration the fact that a married couple would likely want to expand their family with children. Just like the family, the design of the house allows for expansion. Although the actual width of the house is more on the narrow side, it is flexible in the sense that the interior is highly customizable. A blackened brick house. While these narrow houses seem most suitable for an individual person considering their size, many of them are designed with the target audience being a young couple. This is also the case for the skinny scar house in Rotterdam in the Netherlands. This house was actually designed by a Dutch couple, Gwendolyn Huisman and Marijn Boterman, who are both architects. This modern house is actually situated in an old neighborhood. The skinny scar house may be modern, following the new trend of narrow houses, yet its choice of black brick as its exterior is actually supposed to be complementary to the older housing within the neighborhood. The architect couple commented on the facade of their house. The modern house has its own identity with modern details, but still highlights the history of the small gap in the urban context. This house is wider than the previous houses mentioned, since it measures 11 feet. Nevertheless, it is still quite narrow compared to the average home. The couple still found designing the building to be quite challenging, since they wanted to create a space that was still light and lofty, in spite of the size. The couple tried to structure the different levels in a way that would suit their daily schedule. For example, the kitchen is placed on the ground floor, and the bedroom is at the top. The final floor is also where the bathroom is set. This placement allows for the luxury of a skylight above the bathtub. At the front of the house, on the side that faces the street, there are two large windows. These windows are bay windows, so they slightly protrude from the house and have a seat installed, allowing the people inside to sit and look outside. There are also another three windows on the back side of the house. However, the catch is that these windows are actually hidden, since they only show up when there is light coming from the rooms inside. One of the most unique things about this house is that they managed to incorporate a large hammock into one of the floors. This couple was able to make this skinny scar house truly refreshing by mixing both the traditional and the modern in order to appeal to many people. A historic facade. Another innovative design is the narrow house in the town of Sant Cugat, a popular tourist location in the north of Barcelona. Because the location is considered a cultural heritage site, the new house, which was built in between two existing buildings, had to have a facade that complemented its surroundings. The mastermind behind this particular residence is the Barcelonian architect Josep Ferrando. The 176 house E plus M is less than 16 feet wide and is considered a success in terms of its main goal. Josep says that the new house is a fragment that fits with the complex urban conditions, the monastery, the cultural heritage of the street facade and topography. One thing that distinguishes this house from all the ones we have mentioned is its target audience. This is a residence which, from the get-go, is looking to house a family. Many of the other houses is aimed to inhabit couples who may consider expanding later on, but this house has been structured to suit several people. Not only is the bathroom family-sized, there is already a child's bedroom. Josep had structured the house around its different ground levels. For example, the living room has been set on a slightly lower ground, but then it leads to a garden in the back. The clever placement of the living room has also allowed for it to receive the most daylight. While some of the previous houses use dark aesthetics to create depth or to suit their neighboring buildings, the 176 house E plus M uses a much lighter and natural color palette. Ferrando describes the entire home as being built as if it were a hollowed piece of wood. This concept was a very unique one. All of these narrow houses specialize in mixing functionality with art. Designing these kinds of buildings is a challenge that many ambitious architects have already succeeded in, and there will be many more in the future. We hope that you found this interesting, and we'll see you again in the upcoming video.